Your design incorporates a skirt, inches recorded by 5.5 all round, and with mitered corners. Now, when you're doing the panel for the mitered corners, the thickness is 1¾, so therefore you must leave 1¾ on the exterior here to allow for the mitre. So we measure that and equally on both sides and mark it with your square and down this face here. Now we're going to use dowel joints for this joint, which is very, very strong, you know, when you include the surface area. So we're going to do 6 2-inch dowel joints, you know, just begin by inserting the check marks on the various faces. 2 check marks on these reference faces, 2 check marks on these 2 reference edges, and X's on the surfaces to be drilled. Now, we've already marked these, drilled these first holes, as you can see here, to save time. Move this out the way a bit. And we'll swing this around so we have the guides in the front. Now, I'm going to show you another little feature of Dowelmax, which is really important. As you can see, this Dowelmax is used in this configuration for doing these joints. You reference from here, you reference from there, and you drill away. But when you come to do this joint here, you can't fit Dowelmax on. So we solved that problem by removing the clamp bracket, which is not used for reference at all, just for clamping. And we have these threaded holes on the bottom of the reference bracket, and we install that like so. Just takes about 30 seconds to install, to change that over to what we call the second configuration. Now, additionally, because the wood is 1¾ thick, we'll probably have to put a spacer in here just to increase the span of Dowelmax. And make sure. Now, because you used the 1/2-inch spacer to give you the reference space from here down, we have to also do the same for this face joint. Now, as I mentioned, the line for the mitre, in this case we have to align the mitre. The mitred line aligns with this joint, this face here. So we align with the scribed line. And I'm going to use the shorter distance gauge this time. And we're keeping away from the edge, so we'll be drilling 4 and 5. Now you can time this again and you'll see just how quickly it's done. I don't know what other system you could use for this particular joint. I certainly wouldn't use biscuits or pocket holes, that's for sure. And I really don't know how you would do mortise and tenon. Now we're referencing from the first hole this time and we're drilling 4 and 5. Of course, these two lines here are merely for guidance. They're not critical at this point in time. In fact, we'll probably remove them and redo the lines. Okay, now we... I like the dowels to be snug. Gives you a very, very strong joint. And you can now go back to your check marks. Make sure that everything's... Perfect joint, ready to be sanded.